On this episode of 6 months Later, we'll be taking a look at the EcoBee3 smart home thermostat. Does it really save you that much money in energy consumption, and what benefits does it have over its competitor, the Nest thermostat? This is 6 months Later. Smart thermostats have been around for a while now, and were often thought of as one of the first true smart home appliances. It's impossible to talk about smart thermostats without first mentioning the most famous one, the Nest Learning Thermostat. Now, what the Nest does is it's a learning thermostat. It learns the way you like to set it to based on a variety of different factors, including the weather outside, the time of day, and the humidity levels. Then what the Nest does is it applies machine learning, and it learns your habits and anticipates what temperature you're going to want the thermostat set to based on all of those factors it takes into consideration, making adjustments by you to the thermostat less and less likely over time. The EcoBee3, on the other hand, is not a learning thermostat. What the EcoBee is, it's a smarter, programmable thermostat that connects to Wi-Fi, knows whether you're home or not to save on heating and cooling costs, allows you to adjust it from the phone app, and it can read multiple data from multiple sensors in different rooms around your house. Oftentimes in homes and apartments, rooms can vary a few degrees from each other. Now, what the EcoBee can do is it can aggregate all of the temperature and humidity data it receives from multiple sensors in multiple rooms, giving you a true average temperature of your residence, which it will either heat or cool to. Now, this is opposed to what most thermostats still do today, which is just give you a temperature reading of what it is at the thermostat itself. After 6 months of use, I still really like using my EcoBee smart home thermostat. I never find myself going over to change the temperature, which is great because it already knows what temperature I want it to based on my schedule, and it knows if anyone is in my residence or not based on all of the sensors I have in all of the rooms. Those sensors not only take into account temperature and humidity data, but they also act as motion sensors. So the thermostat actually knows if the residence is empty or not, and if it is, it'll then set the temperature higher during the summer and lower during the winter, ultimately saving me energy. With the EcoBee, you can also set vacation reminders, you can access sensor data remotely, and one of my favorite features is it'll give you a visual icon of what the weather is outside as well as what the temperature is. It's great to get that visual reminder of the weather as I'm walking past my thermostat out the door in the morning. And if you want any more information on the weather, just tap the weather information on the thermostat and it'll bring up an extended forecast for you. Now, over the past 6 months, I've been looking at my energy usage from my energy company as compared to last year. And what I've found is on average per month, I'm saving about 7 kilowatt hours, which is about 0.01%. of all of my energy usage. So it's a very, very slim decrease. It's probably not even a decrease at all when you consider the variability of climate from year to year. So at least in my case, I have not seen significant savings with my EcoBee smart thermostat. However, I will say I've only had the thermostat during the winter and spring months so far, and have not had it during the summer months, which are typically, at least in my residence, the months with the highest energy consumption. So I'll be sure to be on the lookout for that data and compare it to last year to see if I see any significant savings this year with my EcoBee. Now, energy savings are of course great, but they weren't the main reason why I wanted an EcoBee smart thermostat. The reason why I bought my EcoBee was, one, I wanted to be able to control my temperature from anywhere I had an internet connection around the world, and two, I wanted my thermostat to integrate with Siri. I wanted to be able to tell Siri to change the temperature to whatever I wanted. Now, at the time when I bought my EcoBee 6 months ago, I was under the impression Siri would be the assistant for my smart home. However, more recently, I've changed my tune towards HomeKit and Siri, using them as the platform that connects all of my smart home devices, and instead I've opted for the Google Assistant through the Google Home appliances I now have in my residence. Now, I'll have a video later on reviewing the Google Home and my thoughts around that, but I wanted to mention this because it's becoming inherently clear that whether you're looking to buy a smart home thermostat or any smart device, you really have to pay attention to what ecosystem the device you're looking at is going to work with. Now, the EcoBee works with Amazon's Alexa and, of course, HomeKit and Siri. But it does not work with the Google Assistant. And I contacted Ecobee's customer support about this a couple months back, and they gave me no indication that they were going to natively support the Google Assistant anytime soon. And then a few months later, they came out with the EcoBee4, which baked Amazon's Alexa right into the thermostat itself. Now, you can get around Ecobee's lack of support for the Google Assistant by using services such as If This Then That or Stringify, but there are some limitations that I've run into specifically with If This Then That. For instance, if you want to set the temperature to 74 degrees for 4 hours, guess what? You can't do that with Google. With If This Then That, you can only set a temperature to an odd numbered degree. So you can't do 74 degrees, but you can do 73. Weird things like that. Now, I just think it's a shame that the Ecobee decided to go all in with Amazon's Alexa. Now, of course, it does work with Apple's HomeKit as well, but by baking Alexa directly into the thermostat, it is clear that Ecobee is betting on Amazon's Alexa as the platform for the smart home. Now, of course, the Ecobee is not the only smart thermostat picking favorites here. Google's Nest smart home thermostat doesn't work with Apple's HomeKit, though that's partially due to Apple's HomeKit having strict hardware requirements for HomeKit-enabled devices. Smart home devices, and especially the ecosystems that support them, are just a mess right now, and smart home thermostats are no exception. I really wish the manufacturers of these devices would, instead of trying to pick one ecosystem over the other, would just take the Philips Hue approach and just work with everything. It would make life so much simpler on us all. That way, we don't have to try to figure out which platform is going to win out in the end. But until that happens, it's just going to be a messy patchwork of smart home devices, and unfortunately, I don't see that getting better anytime soon. Now, back in 2011, when the Nest thermostat first came out and the whole category of smart thermostats really started, it was all about being able to whip out your phone wherever you are and change your temperature and have the thermostat learn your habits and what you want the temperature set to. But today, it's becoming more and more clear that smart home thermostats, along with a category of an entire list of other devices that all connect to your smart home, it's becoming more and more important that you choose what ecosystem you want for your smart home, and that is going to dictate what device, like a thermostat, you are going to get. Right now, it looks like it's either going to be Google's Assistant, which is also the Google Home, or Amazon's Alexa with the Echo, or Apple's HomeKit. Now, smart home discussion aside though, the Ecobee is still a really great thermostat, and especially if you already have an Amazon Echo, or you use Alexa, or you rely solely on Apple's HomeKit and Siri, it's probably going to be the thermostat you're going to want to go with. However, if you're the type of person that does not want to have to program anything, you just want the thermostat to learn what you do and then you never have to touch the thing again, you're probably going to want to stick with the Nest Learning Thermostat. Now, why do I keep recommending the Ecobee over the Nest, even when I used Google Assistant in my apartment? Well, the reason for that is the ability of the Ecobee to aggregate all of that data from multiple sensors in different rooms and give you a true residence temperature. Now, the Nest can do some of this if you have multiple Nest devices, such as their smoke detectors and another Nest thermostat on another floor of your home. But that functionality just does not compare to the affordability and ease of use with the Ecobee with the little sensors they sell, and you can have like 20 to 30 sensors paired to one thermostat. The Nest just cannot compete with that degree of functionality. Now, in the future, if the Nest does offer that functionality, I'll definitely have to take a second look. But for now, I'm sticking with the Ecobee. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder.